Well, I guess. My computer's having some problems. I'm really tired. I guess I'll just have to put this off for tomorrow, maybe tomorrow afternoon. But it's going to be really good. And it's funny. It's really funny. I'll give you a little preview. Whoops, there goes my phone. Let's see here. One. It's pretty funny. I think this is the file. Play. God, I can't find it. Fuck. That was the wrong one. No wonder. It's the one that is. Hold on. Where is it? It's like an hour and. Let me find it. There's two of them right next to each other. Oh, there goes my eye. Oh my god. Let's see here. Ooh, I'm tired. Is that it? Yeah, this one. Play.
Yeah. Anything about it? If I looked at the court documents, I would see that. Things about you and him.
Now, this was a phone call between myself and the woman that used to say her son was Jimmy's son. Now, I'm trying to get info on it, right? Let me see if I can turn this up. Her name's Jessica.
Okay, I can handle it.
Hold on.
Tell her a shithole or something.
Well, what, she lies to me, I will.
They're telling me to call her shithole. I'm waiting for it to start. Because every time I move it, it like moves it way too far because it's a long phone call. It's really funny. Let's see who's in the chat room. Hey, Stabby. This is a phone call. This is something I did to help Jimmy Lethal out. This was on the day that he found out and he went to the court and told them that he wasn't the daddy. In West Virginia, you have to prove you're not the daddy. Then you have to give up your rights as a daddy, which doesn't make sense to me. But it's all right. Let's see here. Okay, this is the bitch that said that he was the daddy.
Jessica? Yeah? You know, I've been dating this guy since the first. And I wanted to know what you knew about him.
I'm talking about Jimmy.
If you don't mind telling me. Hey, he walked away. I got his phone.
I mean, nothing bad.
Nothing bad?
Or his friend,
he's a really good fella.
Yeah.
I think before he met you, he was hurt a lot.
Oh, really? Can you tell me a little bit about that?
I mean, he's been hurt a lot people has done him dirty. I mean, really fucking dirty.
Well, what kind of things did they do to him?
Like, he's been jumped by his ex-girlfriend's boyfriend and everything. He spent countless times in the hospital because people want to be fucking assholes to him.
Now, I've heard some things about you and him. Is there any truth to that talk?
Well, first and foremost, the way me and Jerry talk to each other ain't nothing like that.
Okay.
I'll call him a straight up fucking dick to his face, but it ain't nothing like that. I mean, it's just how me and Jerry are.
And that's not very ladylike. I mean, you are a lady, right?
Yeah.
Do you talk like that on the normal?
Well, to Jerry, yeah.
Anybody else?
No. Because I know Jerry'll say it back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, Jerry's like my best friend. I mean, it ain't nothing like that. I don't look out for Jerry.
Well, I've just heard so much stuff. I mean, yeah, I heard you're pretty. There's some guy you threw through a wall. I heard about that. I don't know.
That's Jimmy.
That you wouldn't do something like that, would you?
The only reason why I've done that is because the father of my son told me the only fucking reason why my mother died was to get the hell away from me.
So you did throw someone through a wall?
Yes, I did.
I had to preface this. Jimmy's been paying child support for a kid that has not been his at all whatsoever. And this woman, who apparently is larger than me, of course, picked him up one day and physically threw him through a wall. Not like at the wall, through the wall. I'm like, you did what? And this woman named Jessica goes on to talk about Jimmy Lethal. And, like, I can't stop her. I mean, she just won't stop. And it's Jimmy is listening to this whole phone call. And I'm doing this as a favor for him. I'm trying to get her to admit to stuff so he can try to get his money back. Like, that she knew the kid wasn't his. I'm trying to help. Yeah, I wouldn't mind doing this again. You know, trying to get her to admit that I knew the baby wasn't his. You know, I needed the money. Something like that. But let's hear what else Jessica had to say about dear old Jimmy. Hold on, I gotta push play again. I hope you can hear it.
Like right through the wall?
Yes, I did.
You must be strong.
Well, not really. I mean, it's only when people piss me off.
So you threw someone through a wall just because of what they said? It wasn't like they laid hands on you.
He laid hands on me. He beat the hell out of me for 3 months straight.
Oh, that was a lie.
Oh, really? How big of a guy is this? I mean, that's pretty bad. How big is he compared to you?
He's skinny.
Uh-huh.
And he's taller than me, and I picked his ass up and threw him through a wall.
But yet, he beat you up for 3 months. I mean, to me, if you can throw someone through a wall, like straight through a wall, how could they beat you up? I mean, you sound like a smart, strong lady. Am I right?
I mean, I fought back, but I gave up after a while because every time I would hit him, he'd hit me harder.
No, come on. I mean, just be honest. I mean, maybe you just lost your cool. I've done that before. I've lost my cool. Does that happen to you sometimes?
Yes.
Like I'll mouth off. Or don't you tell anybody, but I'll mouth off.
Oh, I ain't gonna tell nobody nothing.
Oh, that's
but, when I threw this guy through a wall, it got enough. I finally had enough, and that's the day I left him, too.
But in all fairness, you know, if he was hurting you, did you go to Divas or the police? Did you make a report?
No, I didn't make a report because he said if I told anybody what he'd done, he'd kill he clearly one I knew and cared about and loved.
But yet you can pick him up and throw him through a wall? I'm just trying to wrap my mind around this. Why you would be afraid of such a... He sounds like a puny man. You know, why would you be afraid of him? Why would you give that threat credibility? Because like I said, you sound like a strong, smart woman. You do. And if you're a friend of Jimmy's, I don't know.
Yeah, the way Jerry talks about him, that's Jerry's best fucking friend right there.
Wait a minute, this guy that beats up women is his best friend?
Hey,
I see a lot of people around Jerry, so I don't know who's who. I just enjoy Jerry. He's a nice guy.
I didn't know Jerry at the time.
Mm-hmm.
But the more me and Jerry got to talk and I found out that he knew Jimmy, I was like, oh, fuck. He goes, what? I was like, Jimmy's the father of my son. He goes, oh, no. I was like, it's not going to be a problem or anything like that because I have nothing away for Jimmy. I have no feelings whatsoever.
But he's the daddy of your child?
Well, he was until he gave up his parental rights.
And you threw him through a wall? Like, right through the wall?
Yeah, this was before I got pregnant with my son.
Oh, my goodness. Well, how's your son? I mean, amidst all this craziness.
He's good. He's with his papa all this weekend.
He's not with you?
Mm-mm.
Are you just having a good weekend partying?
No, I don't party anymore.
Well, I mean, you must be enjoying yourself this weekend somehow. I mean, I assume this is an infant, a toddler or something like that.
He's actually 16 months old.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So does he look like the daddy, or?
Nope.
Well, who does he look like?
He looks like me.
Aw, that's nice. Interesting. So he gave up his rights.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
I don't know. We had court Monday.
There was a DNA test.
We were even in there 5 minutes.
Jesus.
And his lawyer speaks up and goes, Mr. Woman wants to give up his parental rights. I was thinking in my head, I was like, are you fucking serious right now? You're not even going to fucking try?
Well, that must have been hurtful to you.
No, it was actually amazing. I was thinking to myself, I was like, yes! I ain't gonna deal with his ass no more.
Now, wait a minute. You say that, are you kidding me? All this, that sounds like you're hurt. And then you say it was effing amazing. What about your child? I mean, that's his daddy, right?
Yeah, but he has nothing to do with him, though.
But that's still his daddy. I mean, that's got to be... Like, when he's older, that's got to hurt. I mean, what are you going to do for the kid? I mean, I don't know what I would do if I was in your situation. I mean, maybe there's another daddy. Maybe there is. That would be the best situation. If I were you, I would hope that there was a different daddy. Because that's got to be bad.
Yeah, he didn't even fucking try. And I mean, I'm sitting there. I wanted to speak out and be like, you didn't even try, dude. Why?
My goodness. Well, maybe there'll be a different daddy and he'll have somebody in his life. Do you think that might happen? Or?
I hope so in the near future.
Was there another father, possibly? Because that would be best. Because, I mean, this guy sounds like an asshole.
Well, my best friend, guy friend, he's gay, but...
Uh-huh.
He's been in Thomas's life ever since he was 3 months old.
Well, did you hook up with him?
No.
Well, I mean, I'm just kind of hoping you had hooked up with somebody else. Well, you don't